Hello, Delano. Winston, wondering, where are the bombers? Lieutenant Dan was to deliver 6 strategic bombers with 12 infantry to London, turn 3. Asking where they are. Yes. Hello, Winston. I'm afraid that we will not be able to put the 6 strategic bombers and the 12 infantry into London. Corpo 24 has informed me that it is just 2-1 bomber and 2 units per territory. Sorry about that. You see, Roosevelt, we need the forces. Does that mean you'll still be bringing me the transports laden with infantry and tanks to London? So very sorry, chap, but Corpo 24 and Lieutenant Dan both agree that the transports will go to Gibraltar, where we will continue to build a bulkhead against the Italians. Well, General Fun has advised that we need to open a second front in Europe as a salient against the Soviets. Well, Winston, unfortunately, General Fund is a rank amateur and a hothead. We will make a move into Europe, turn 8. Winston, he's still there? I'll tell you what. We can drop 1 bomber into London, 1 into Scotland, and if you move forces there, we could do 1 into Ireland, and that would be 3 bombers and 6 units. Would that work for you, Winston? Would that be okay? Yes, of course. We will take any aid that we can get. It must be very late over there, Winston. Yes, Delano. Later than you can imagine.
So yeah, he's got the long trench coat.
It'll either hit or it won't. Okay.
Yeah. Man, they're gorgeous.
Some squatters, some standards. But yeah.
That's awesome.
Which is everything. 2-2s, 1 and 4.
And I like the coasters too. I love the coasters.
Yeah, Rich made those just for us. He said he can make more too, so
that's awesome.
Yeah.
And then we'll have a set of grasshopper dice. It's going to be a prize. Complete roundel set with the BBR roundels in them.
Nice.
Russia, the Russian one. This is $80 from HBG. And this whole set, here's the number of values in each one. You don't need more than 5 French.
But this is a prize.
Matt Todd sent us this. He had a sublimation printed on sheet metal.
Wow.
And so people like Moose Cow, they magnetize their roundels and stick it on there. Like this is a sweet prize.
Beautiful.
Mr. Scrubber's painted pieces.
Is that a calendar then?
Yes.
Okay.
Moffett Field sent this to us.
I got 1-2. Is that correct? You got 3-2.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Hell yeah.
You got 2 for the bomber and 2 for
Toro. I got it.
Hits.
Okay.
So, nice. This is pretty neat. Actually, would it be better? Yes. I'm going to turn it this side so that we know what's in there.
Yeah.
I didn't even think to look on the back. But that's cool. So, yeah, he sent that. We've got gift cards to HBG. And we've got these grabs of 10.
Beautiful navy pieces.
Yeah, dude, he really went all out on these. Like, these aircraft carriers, the battleship, he painted the deck.
Wow.
And then that, that's just, it's beautiful.
Yes, sir.
And then even the destroyer with the yellow tip on it. Alright, let's look at these real quick, dude. These infantry are nice, but these tanks, that's where it's at.
Oh, yeah.
They all have different names on them, too. Which is awesome.
But you still own it.
And then German Air Force. He painted the cockpits and everything.
Oh, so cool.
Great. Last battle right here.
So you heard it here. Bbr St. Louis is the best Bbr all time. Amazing. Cool prizes, man.
We've also got a BB3 map coming and a BBR4 map coming. Whoever decides to put in for those, I'll have to ship it to you, but you'll get it.
Okay.
So.
General Fund reporting for duty, inspired by the amazing prizes and off of the day one win. The Lieutenant General is going to day two, feeling confident as they face their opponents, the Mad Moose Disease. They'd be playing on the cool table with the amazing painted pieces by Mr. Skrubert. Lieutenant Dan had been up, had been working into the night, developing his strategy for the U.S., inspired by, again, an initial misunderstanding of the bomber rule. Still being refined and worked out, I was to play the British, and Corpo 24 was at home playing the Soviet Union, which is his, in his wheelhouse. So we're feeling good going into day two, and we had no idea we were about to walk into a literal buzzsaw. By this point in the game, I had ceded full control to Corpo 24 and to Lieutenant Dan, trusting the experience over, you know, what my instincts are, and everything was playing out, was developing, and then a controversial decision to put a factory in Egypt early by Corpo 24. I didn't agree with it, but I, of course, saw the benefit of it. We agreed to put the factory in Egypt, and that proved to be the impetus for our entire downfall. There was a battle there where Italy rolled through 12 dice and hit with 9, and I mean, what can I say? That was it for us. That was the rest of our day. The dice were definitely not on our side. We saw crazy things happen. There was a destroyer that took down so many units that it just make you sick. Anti-aircraft rolls where we're hitting 2 out of 3. This just continued the entire day. And what happened is that we saw a masterclass moves by the Mad Moose Cows, by Madman Moscow and Mr. Skrubert. They took us apart piece by piece, annihilated us, and, you know, I totally got to tip your hat to them. By turn 4, we knew it was over, and it was just 4 turns of just, for us, just agony of, you know, watching literally almost every single space on the board be taken over. They ended the game with 24 of a possible 28 points. We, you know, held on with 4. And like I said, got to see a, you know, really a flawless victory from Mad Moose Cow. And, the yeah, Mad Moose disease. And anyway, hats off to them, and that was it. That was our day. Now, the lesson that I took away from playing the Allies in a game this long, this 12 hours just grind fast games, is that, and this goes back to my instincts as a player. It's probably wrong, but you know, I feel like as the Allies, you have to fight those little battles that, yes, you're going to lose. You know, don't do that. Don't do that. They're just going to destroy it. Well, I heard that over and over and over, and it was always true. I'm not saying it wasn't always true. However, the Axis start with such an advantage in forces, especially Japan, that I feel like the Allies have to kill them by a death by a thousand cuts. And I just feel like, you know, to put the two guys there to take over the territory, put the two guys in, now they're going to die. Well, the impetus is now put on the Axis player to decide to do that and to make them think of how they're going to do that. And it's just a small thing, but it adds up over a 12-hour game. And these little battles and these little things, they're just annoying. Well, you know, again, that's true, but it takes its toll. And, I'm sure it's wrong, but my strategy for the Allies going forward is to make the Axis fight for everything that they get. You know, no quarter. You know, Tarleton's quarter, that's just, you don't give any. No quarter anywhere. Fight for everything. Don't let anything go by easily. And yeah, there's times when you've got to back out, and I understand that, and you should, but at the same time, you've got to grind on the Axis, and you've got to make them replace units, and you've got to make them shuffle units places that they didn't want to and didn't plan to. And I think that's the only way to win as the Allies. So that's General Fund's closing thoughts on that. Again, want to thank everyone that I met at the tournament. All just great people. It was a grind, but it was just so fun, so worth it. It was such a great setup with having this at the hotel, because when I was done for the night, I could just go up, I could just take the elevator, go back to my room, crash out, and I didn't have to worry about, oh, now I gotta get in my car, I gotta drive down the road, I gotta check into my hotel, and then I gotta drive back to the location, do it again. You know, there's none of that. It was just all right there. I will definitely 100% go next year, and I would recommend anyone that can, please do this, or you should do this. It was a great event. Everything was really set up very, very well. Everything went real smooth, and the prizes were great. And again, I thank everyone that I met and everyone involved, and hope to do it again next year.
Hey, what the hell are you doing?
Mongolian?
What the hell Mongolian doing here? You Mongolian! Don't you break down my wall!
You pay now! Now!
What happened to you, China? You used to be cool.
Hey, China's still cool. You pay later. Later!
Please subscribe to General Fund for less dishonor.